In tourism news, the owners of the land in St. Lucia have acquired the assets of the insolvent development company associated with that property. This is expected to pave the path for a brighter future at one of the island's leading hotels. The land in St. Lucia announced that the more than 140 owners of the resort have successfully pooled their resources to create a fully owned, operated, and managed hotel and residence community. John Copeland, executive director of the body corporate, headed a consortium to acquire the developer's US $11 million in assets. He has said the acquisition allows the new management team to be fully focused on their energies to upgrade the guest experience at the already highly rated resort. With 85 of the 146 spacious and fully loaded designer suites in the current rental pool, The Landings has recently introduced a premier concierge service, butler service, and new restaurant, as well as upgrades to its water sports facilities. A new retail shop, deli, and laundry are on the cards. In other tourism news, a quick note about the appointment of Kevin Hughes as general manager at Coconut Bay Resort Spa in Viewfort, St. Lucia. Kevin Hughes has been appointed general manager of St. Lucia's Coconut Bay Beach Resort Spa. In his new role, Hughes will oversee the daily operations and a staff of over 300 for this 250-room, all-inclusive property on St. Lucia's south coast. Hughes' hospitality career spans 30 years. He was the director of food and beverage at Coconut Bay for 2 years prior to his appointment as the resort's general manager. Mr. Hughes has worked in a number of places around the world, including the Crystal Palace Casino in Nassau, Bahamas. He also served as director of food and beverage in Sandals Resorts in Jamaica and St. Lucia. St. Lucia joined the world in observing World AIDS Day on December 1st. The day's events featured a number of activities, including an exhibition. A statement marking the occasion was presented by the Acting Senior Medical Officer for Infectious Disease, Alicia Jebatisse.
The newly diagnosed cases of HIV continue to be on the increase, despite our prevention efforts. You're looking at in 2013, we had 64 cases of HIV infection, and they were newly diagnosed. We have the males accounting for 72% of these cases, and the females 27%. And we have 1% that is an unknown case, and it's possibly because of improper documentation where this information was not pulled in. The age group of 25 to 49 years accounts for 66% of the cases reported, and the number of males reported triples that compared to that of the females. If we look at the age group, which is 15 years to 24 years, which is a younger age group, we have about 11% of the total cases falling into that group, and there's only one newly diagnosed case being female, whereas you have six being males. So obviously the males are the gender that you have to look at more clearly. At December 2013, which is last year, we had 623 people living with HIV recorded in our national register. It is quite obvious when we look at the data that the men tend to be the ones being more affected, and of course we see an increased trend in men having sex with men, what we call MSM. And that is one of the things we need to look into also.
Another health official, Lorna Wilson, also spoke on World AIDS Day, noting that although Ebola is consuming the world's attention right now, HIV/AIDS was still a major health threat to the region.
Now all we hear is Ebola, but we need people to know that HIV is still there. We're still having people getting infected with the condition every year, and it is a highly preventable disease. So we're here to let people know that HIV is still around, and they have things that they can do to prevent the infection. Like the film says, zero infection, zero discrimination, getting to zero.
The LGBT community was also involved in the observances of World AIDS Day, seeking to ensure that all sectors of society benefit from AIDS education activities.
United is Strong is an NGO that has been reaching out to men having sex with men and other marginalized groups like sex workers, most at risk, you know, youth. And what we're doing is simply bringing the commodities to the people today. So we have a display here going on at Blue Coral Mall, where we are distributing condoms, lubricants. We are giving information and we are answering any questions people have about sex and STIs. We need to break the taboo that sex is something that's supposed to be secret. We need to talk about these issues because as we understand it, people have questions and they are not asking. And you know, you cannot be ignorant of the issue or the facts.
On that note, we will pause for a minute. There is more news ahead on Calabash TV.